To get started on doing this yourself, go to the link in the description to go to GitHub and claim the Mario Kart 64 HD texture ROM folder. You will need to have the latest version of Project 64 and a US copy of Mario Kart 64. You can use this checksum to make sure that your ROM copy is valid. Once you've downloaded the zip file, go to your installation folder where you have Project 64 3.0 and go under the plugin folder, then GFX, then GlideN64, and make sure that you have these folders created, including the high-res texture folder. Inside here is where you're going to put the folder for Mario Kart 64 texture pack. Once you have everything moved over to this location, go into Project N64 and make sure that you can run the ROM without any texture packs. Then, when the ROM is highlighted and this is the last ROM that you've opened up, go into Options, then Configuration. Go for Config Mario Kart 64 because we want to only modify this specific game. Open the tab to open up plugins. Then make sure the GlideN64 is selected as the plugin. Then go back out to Options, then Graphic Settings. Go to Texture Enhancement, and click the checkbox that says Use Texture Pack. Make sure that you have selected the folder, the path to the folder for the texture pack, including the cache path and the dump path, which should all be in the same relative location as your Project 64 3.0 installation. You can modify some other settings if your computer can handle it, including the size of the memory cache for the advanced textures, and go over to emulation and adjust for the resolution. With the texture packs, you can use a 16:9 ratio and a lot of anti-aliasing if your computer can handle it. Once you have all this modified, save and close. You can save and close, and then you can launch the game from there. The game with the texture packs will take a very long time to load, especially if you have a very slow computer. It can normally take about 10 minutes to load them all up. But once you have this all set, you're ready to go. There we go. Load into this for about the second time. I had to load this beforehand just to make sure it works. So right ahead, I can notice a lot of details with the character models and the the backgrounds, the floor textures, the wall textures, much more clean. Of course, the 16:9 aspect ratio is pretty good, but you kind of expect that with the latest version of Project 64 and other emulators being able to finally do this. Just gotta play by myself just to show off how this all looks. Sure, I can do the 150. Now, this is also a very nice selection of HD textures just for the portraits. And I believe many of the in-game icons, including the items and some of the UI elements, should also be in high definition. Pretty much anything that looks like a sprite should be much cleaner now. I already did Mushroom Cup, and I don't want to do it again for this recording because it's going to look pretty boring. So let's just jump right into Star Cup. The wire texture on the right already looks a lot better. Yeah, the portraits on the left are much cleaner, the UI is much cleaner. I believe that turned on anti-aliasing as well. So there shouldn't be a lot of jaggies around here. Oh yeah, that boom model looks great. And so is that banana. Yeah, a couple of the texts that appear, like the boing and the plomp, they look a little cleaner, but I'm not sure if they are any different textures. It could just be the resolution. This is 1080p, by the way. It's the highest that I can do on here. The full HD is a lot better than the 480 that the N64 was stuck with. And it wasn't even like true 480, it was still dirty. Almost got that snake right there. I'm genuinely curious if Toad and Yoshi are objectively the faster characters, even when I'm trying to do my snake tricks. Because I know that, like, Bowser and Donkey Kong, and I believe Wario is a heavyweight as well. They have very low acceleration, but the top speed should ideally be very fast, but I still want to think that it's just a bug in the programming. Someone freaked up and thought that inertia doesn't apply to the low characters, so they just, like, go beyond all top speed for whatever reason. Whoops, I spun too much. Should actually toggle the right part of the map. Here we go. Oh wow, I thought they'd rubber band sooner. I wonder if there's a mod out there that actually disables the rubber banding. I'm sure it's just something in the coding that can be manipulated with. Because while I do find that, yeah, it's important that single player has, like, some nice moments, it's not very interesting when you always see the exact two same opponents trying to catch up to you at impossible speeds all the time. I know that there's a mod out there that does allow more human items to come about, like, the CPUs never use red shells, but you can mod it to make sure that they do that, and supposedly, according to the current logic, they can use it fine. I just thought it was too oppressive and unfair, but hey, they're the ones who designed the broken wet items in the first place. Freaking Nintendo. Shell guy, nice. And of course Mario's gonna get in my way. That didn't work. This will. Oh, he still caught me off guard. Oh, that's Mario Kart. Little did I know, I had to worry about Wario this entire time. Alright, I'm gonna have another video linking to just me continuing to show this off, but I hope everyone enjoyed this first race so far with the high definition textures.